So this is about another picture about the inflorescence and the leaf. Yes, you can clearly have the somewhat the pink color in the node. You can identification of the apamarga. So there will be a swollen node and somewhat pink color at the particularly in the node. So it will be present. Okay. And also you can observe the longitudinal, the furrows are present. So because of this longitudinal furrows, you can feel the roughness while you, when you touch the stems of this plant. So this is the stems of apamarga. So you can take about the swarupa. It is a wild perennial erect pubescent herb. It is a wild, it is commonly available as a weed throughout India. So we used to get this plant in any part, even in the wastelands, anywhere you can observe. So this plant you will get. So it is a wild perennial, bahuvarshayu, erect, the stem will be straight, pubescent. There is a presence of hairs on the stem, on the leaves. Okay, so whole the leaf, inflorescence, stem, the whole plant, the hairs will be present. Pubescent herb. There is a chupa, which grows about 1 to 3 feet height. Which grows about 1 to 3 feet height. The length of the apamarga. Okay, about the stem. So as you have seen, stem is erect, that is above the ground level, that is aerial, branched. So at every node you have observed that, so at the axillary bud is going to continuous as a branch. Okay, so erect, branched, hairy, that is the pubescent. Okay, so green, the whole stem green. At the node it is pink color. Okay, green, herbaceous, it is soft, stem will be soft, but woody at below. At the below, that is the lower part of the stem will be woody, but when it comes to the upper part, it is soft, that is herbaceous. And nodes and internodes are prominent. So you have observed the nodes and internodes, you can easily differentiate. Thick node will be present, prominent thick nodes, and the nodes are violet or pink color. Violet or pink color at the nodes. Okay, next about the leaves. So you can take about the leaves. Type of leaf is simple, arrangement is opposite, even you can say like opposite decusset also. Okay, type of leaf is simple, arrangement opposite, shape elliptic, elliptic or semi-orbicular, that you have seen, somewhat round shaped, that is semi-orbicular, elliptic, that is broadest at the middle, gradually tapering towards the base as well as the apex, that is called elliptic, or somewhat round, that is called orbicular, and the apex is both acute as well as obtuse, that is round apex, sharp apex. Both characters are present in this plant, acute and obtuse. And the size is 4 to 12 centimeter in length. Size of the lamina is 4 to 12 centimeter in length and 5 to 7 centimeter width will be present. And the surface, that is upper surface as well as the lower surface. That's why they used to call whole plant is pubescent, but the leaves are tomentose. Thickly arrangement of the hairs will be present in case of the leaves, whereas in case of the inflorescence or the stem, there will be there also hairs will be present, but compared to the leaves, it is lesser in quantity. And the petiole is short. Petiole is short. Okay. Next, we'll move to the inflorescence. So you can observe. So this is the based on this color they have given the synonym as Mayuratha or Mayurashikha. Mayurashikha, there is another one more non-detailed rag is there. Mayurakha, the crest of the peacock is having the color as like that of Mayura. That is the inflorescence of apamarga is having the color as like that of the crest of peacock. Okay, based on this color they used to give the synonym. So next, this is also another picture which shows about the inflorescence. So this is the main peduncle. So over that, the inflorescence they used to, that is the flowers they used to attach. The flowers are sessile. They have directly attached to the main peduncle. It is a type of spike inflorescence. So this is another picture you can clearly observe how the flowers are arranged. So the each flower, this is the open flower. so because this the adashalya adhamukha or so this is the reason the bracteoles are having sharp point like structures. Okay, so in this picture you can clearly open this the open flowers of the apamargha. Okay, so this is another picture you can observe clearly. So in the main peduncle you can observe the tomentose, thickly arrangement of the hairs will be present, pubescent hairs will be present on the main peduncle. Okay, so here almost all the whole the inflorescence is opened, that is the completely developed flowers are there. Okay, so here you can observe the fruit, this is the fruit, and here there will be seed is there. So this is the fruit. So if you open that the calyx part, so you will get the inside the seeds are present. So this is also another picture of fruit. So this is whole plant. You can observe root. This is the root, the whole plant of patra, pushpa, phala, moola, kanda. So all the parts are there. The useful part is panchanga. So this is another picture of apamarga. Okay, this is about the roots. So you can take about the inflorescence. The type of inflorescence is a spike. There is a type of raceme inflorescence. Okay, a spike with a reflexed flowers, reflexed or deflexed, that is adhomukha, deflexed flowers. So arranged on the long peduncle, on main the long peduncle, over that the flowers they used to present. Okay, next, as usual, the flowers are actinomorphic. So in any directions you will get equal halls, bisexual, having both male and female sexual organs, complete, that is presence of calyx, corolla, androecium, gynoecium, all the four whorls are present. That's why they used to call it as incomplete flower. And the color of the flowers is, in the earlier condition it was green. And the bracteoles have spinous tips. I have shown the bracteoles, it is having a spinous tips, and the flowers are sessile. Flowers are sessile, and the calyx will be persistent. Okay, so this is about the inflorescence. Next, about fruit. Fruit type of fruit is an indehiscent achene, A-C-H-E-N-E. So this is the type of fruit, an indehiscent achene. So enclosed within the persistent perianth and the bracteoles. The fruit will be covered by the persistent perianth and the bracteoles. Seeds are endospermic. Okay. Next, utpatti sthana. So it is common in tropical and subtropical parts of India. So throughout India it is available, this plant. Okay. Next, the active principles. Chemical composition. Acaranthin. The main active principle of apamarga is acaranthin, alkaloid, and saponin A, B, C, D. And the potassium salts, oleonolic acid, and ecodisone. So these are the some of the important active principles of apamarga. Okay. So next, so these are the chemical structures. There is saponins. So these are the chemical structures. Next, about the types. So according to Bhavaprakash Nigantu, Dhanvantara Nigantu, he used to mention about two types of apamarga. Shweta apamarga and Rakta apamarga. Shweta apamarga, it is Acaranthus aspera. And for Rakta apamarga, the botanical source is Acaranthus rubrofusco. Acaranthus rubrofusco is Rakta apamarga. And Shweta apamarga is Acaranthus aspera. According to Kayadeva Nigantu, it is of three types. Apamarga, Vashira and Ramata. Apamarga, Vashira and Ramata. These are the three types of apamarga according to Kayadeva Nigantu. And according to about the Rasapanchaka, pharmacodynamics. So the Panchanga as the useful part, that is Panchanga is having Katutiktarasa. Katutiktarasa mainly Tikshna Guna. Lagu Ruksha, Tikshna and Saraguna. Lagu Ruksha, Tikshna and Saraguna. Katubipaka will be present. Ushna Virya and Kafavata Shamaka. Okay, the Panchanga, whole Panchanga is having Katu Tiktarasa, Lagu Ruksha, Tikshna, Saraguna, Katu Vipaka, Ushna Virya, and Kafavata Shamaka. But whereas the Phala is having Madhura Madhura Shita. Phala, that is Madhura Rasa, Madhura Vipaka, Shita Virya, but the Guna is having Ruksha Guna. Madhura Rasa, Madhura Vipaka, Ruksha Guna, Shitavirya, and it is Vata Khara. So here Vata, it does Vata Vardhana because of the Shitavirya. So Shitavirya, it does Vata Vardhana, and also the Guna is Ruksha Guna. So which suppresses the Madhura Rasa and Madhura Vipaka, and it is going to act like a Vata Vardhaka. Next, so these are the benefits of Apamarga, that it promotes the, especially in case of like a Mutra properties, healthy urinations, it is useful, and it supports the healthy digestion, as which will increases, which will help in case of ajirna on the conditions. Okay, now also it is rich in potassium, so this is one of the important active principles, the potassium also, because of this it is going to helpful in case of this diuretic properties. Okay, so which and also which will promotes in healthy heart functioning, and also it promotes the skin health for itching and various other disorders. Karma and rogagnata, so shirovirechaka karma, that is acharya charaka has mentioned it under shirovirechaka, it does shirovirechaka karma, so useful in case of shiro rogas, also it having agni deepaka, so that is indicating case of agni mandya, and also it is having pachaka and rochaka karma, so indicated in case of ajirna aruchi, and also it is having chardi nigrahana karma, so indicating case of chardi, and also it is having admana hara, so indicating case of admana, and also it is having arshogna and kandugna karma, so it is indicating case of arsha, kandu and kushta. Okay, next amayika prayoga, therapeutic uses. So in case of arsha, so apamarga moola, it is grinded with the madhu, and that is given along with the thandulodaka. You can administer along with the thandulodaka. Apamarga moola grinded with the madhu, and it is administered along with the thandulodaka. It is useful in case of arsha. In case of raktarsha, apamarga bija churna is given along with the thandulodaka. In case of raktarsha, apamarga bija churna is given along with the thandulodaka. And in case of vishuchika, it is apamarga moola kalka is given along with the jala. In case of vishuchika, apamarga moola kalka is given along with the jala. In case of nadi runa, the taila prepared from apamarga phala is applied along with the cow's urine, gomutra, in case of nadi runa. In case of basmaka roga, in excessive hunger, that is basmaka roga, you can prepare a gruel out of apamarga bija, dugda and godarasa. Godarasa is a type of meat juice. Okay, so you can prepare a gruel with the help of apamarga bija and dugda, so it is very effective in case of basmaka roga. And in case of dantagata shula, so you can just prepare the swarasa with the help of patra, so that you can keep with the help of cotton swab. So here there will be danta shula is there, just you can apply externally. Patra swarasa is very effective in case of dantagata shula. And in case of ashmari, the apamarga kshara is given along with ajamutra. In case of ashmari, there is apamarga kshara is given along with the ajamutra. And in case of the dog bite, that is patra swarasa is applied over the wound as kinihi, that helps which helps in healing the wounds, that is runaropana karma. So in case of dog bite, patra swarasa you can apply over the wounds. Next, the useful part, that is panchanga we are using. Apart from that, you can mention moola, patra, bija, kshara also you can mention, and matra. Moola churna can give 3 to 6 gram, bija churna 1 to 3 grams, kshara around about 500 mg to 1 gram. So vishishta yoga, apamarga kshara, apamarga thaila, guda pippali, abhayalavana, jyotishmati taila, trifladi taila, maha panchagavya gruta. Okay, so these are some of the important preparations, and also you can note about the preparation of apamarga kshara also. Okay, so this is about detailed description of apamarga. Okay, thank you.